Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And these parables of the New Testament are on my fingertips. And here I'm going to explain St. Luke 10:17-24. Holy Gospel of our supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. Allah is in Arabic. The word Allah is from Illah. Illah used to be the tribal father. Al-Illah means the spiritual father. These Mohammedans don't know what Allah stands for because they worship moon and star, which is a rabbi. This is moon and star. So their Islam is this one. Real Islam is this one which Jesus preached, of sun, primary source of light. So here it is, Jesus had two layers of laborers. Jesus did not have any disciple. The root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline a natural person through the moral laws of Moses, how to behave in this world, and that created kingdom of heaven. Heaven is here. Royal kingdom of God is inside my heart, just the opposite. So you have to be careful, you know, what you say. So this is the royal kingdom of God and kingdom of heaven. And this is my book, which I have revised it. Nobody appreciates this, so even I give them free, they don't want it. So, the inner one is a heart, and the outer 70 was, inner one 12 was of heart, and the outer one was of the, our physical body, which the moral teachers, the which the rabbis used to be. So Jesus came to fulfill the law, and he did it in 70s. They were preached gospel, which is the oral Torah, and they were well versed in the scripture, which is written Torah. What is scripture? It could be corrupted. So they rectified the, darned the holes in the old cloth, which is scripture milk. And then they were fed meat of Jesus, which is the oral Torah, as they were joined him. So, here we go. The 70 in twos, not 72, 70s in twos, in cup of pair, outer circle laborers of Jesus, and not the once more disciples of the rabbis who trained the natural boys through the moral of Moses, returned rejoicing and said to Jesus, Lord, now in royal kingdom of God we don't have Lord. In the inner 12 there is no Lord. In inner 12 we have Father God, and we are sons of the Most High. Whereas the rabbis, they were reflection. John the Baptist, you know, John the Baptist is here. A witness to the light, but not the light. These 70 are here. And these 12 are here. 12. Inner circle. That's why Jesus, when he, before he started washing their feet, he took the outer garment out. Outer garment means this physical body. He took them into their heart, where the royal kingdom of God is. Kingdom of heaven is outside in law and order. So they, for them, you know, we royal priests are the Lord of the Sabbath. So Jesus, that's why they address Jesus Lord, because he was Lord of the Sabbath, to which the 70 belonged. To the 70 was concerned with Sabbath, but not the 12. For every day for them is a Sabbath. 70 belonged to, as the rabbis are, the 70, they worked for their living, whereas the 12, they devoted their whole life for preaching gospel. And they did not work for money, but for gospel treasures. Which the 70 belong to, as the rabbis are. Even the demons are subject to us because of your name. In honor of Christ Jesus, they had learnt the Oral Torah. So when the rabbi possessed the knowledge of Oral Torah and the scripture, old cloth, which is scripture, and the new treasures, then he is a perfect. Then Jesus need not come, because they became greedy. The knowledge of Oral Torah was taken away from them. So anybody who thinks of money when preaching gospel, he won't get anything. So these evangelists and all that, you know, they just empty drums making much noise. Even the demons are subject to us because of your name, or in honor of you. These were prepared for the John the Baptist, the ideal rabbi, Matthew 13, verse 52. Jesus said, I have observed Satan, the tares, Jews outwardly, and not of the heart, as the Samaritans were. Now the Jews outwardly, they were very much resistant to gospel, because they wanted to more Jew outwardly, tares, and not the spiritual one, fall like lightning from the sky. Behold, I have given you the power to tread upon serpents, are the evil spirited greedy people. They always resisted gospel because their position was shaken. Evil spirited people who create infighting and kill, sectarian riots they call. They cause sectarian riots and people die. That is why John the Baptist called the temple priest the brood of vipers. It was these evil-spirited people that Moses lifted up, and not the snake that wriggles, not the snakes that wriggle on the ground. You know, people, when people take literal sense, you know, but they are in parables, you know, analogies. Remember that, you know, when Moses killed one Egyptian who did wrong to a laborer or a slave, they killed him. That were the chosen people. So next day, Moses came and two of them was fighting, you know, chosen people were fighting. And Moses wanted to intervene. And they said, who made you the judge among us? Cat lost. And that was the snake between them, you know, they fighting with each other. And when Moses made them the sons of Abraham, then there was union. That means there were no more fighting, they were living in brotherhood. And that is lifting up the snake. And scorpions, scorpion means those people, you know, who try to sting or kill people. And scorpions are evil-spirited people. The top-honored priests in the churches, they are scorpions. But many people don't know. They have killed their congregations. They do what their rabbis, this new rabbi with dog collar will tell them. These dog collar priests, they are thieves of the order of Judas Iscariot. Judas Iscariot used to hold the purse. Whenever he wanted money, he would steal money from the purse. Same way, people donate to the church. At the end of the month, the priest puts his hand into that purse of donations and steals as his salary. That is, he is not working for God, but working for mammon. And he retires at the age of 65 or so. He is retired. And in Oxford, you know, it went to a big question debate. In the audience, I was sitting, and over there we had one retired vicar, David Patterson, and he was the main person to be questioned. And Nicky Campbell addressed him, "Here you have a vicar, David Patterson." He said, "Oh, don't call me vicar, I have retired. I'm no more vicar, don't address me vicar." Then he addressed him as reverend, and he was happy. So you can see what type of super blind guides you have. And people sitting there, professors and everybody, have no idea what's happening. Because they are super donkeys carrying holy books. You can see how they argue with each other. When they are snakes, you know. And when we have one father, we are all sons. If you understand that, you will love each other and there will be no infighting. Upon the full, all scorpions, and upon the full force of the enemy, and nothing will harm you because you have the knowledge of Oral Torah. The very root of the written Torah. Written Torah is a tree, you know. The tree that you can see is the written Torah. The one roots, they are the oral Torah, which you can't see. You have to perceive the tree has a root. Same way, everything of God is to be perceived. Everything of Yahweh, the creator of nature, you can see with two natural eyes. You need the third eye of logical reasoning. So, roots of the written Torah. Nevertheless, do not rejoice because the spirits are subject to you, but rejoice because your names are written in heaven that belong to Yahweh. You know, unless you are predestined, you are not attracted to gospel. Your gospel, you must long for it. If you cannot long for it, you can't get it. So that's why to get gospel, you have to ask, seek, and knock. Ask question. Dead man doesn't ask question. So gospel is not for the living dead. Who are book people, but those who are asking, who are living, and they will ask question. Then they will become twice born, and then they start seeking gospel. And the seeking the narrow gate that leads to the royal kingdom of God, or the royal vineyard of our Father, where the true vine Christ Jesus is planted by our Father. We must craft ourselves to that true vine if we want to preach gospel. At that very moment, he rejoiced in the Holy Spirit and said, I give you praise, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. For although you have hidden these things from the wise and learned, wise and learned mean those university theologians in Jerusalem who were thinking they are wise and learned, but the gospel came to the village people who were not drunk with the old wine of the letters. I am a retired lecturer in metallurgy. I am not drunk with the old wine of the letters as the university professors of theology are. So I can preach gospel, but they can't have it. Once you are drunk with the old wine, you desireth not the new. You will say old is good. From the wise and learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Childlike people, impartial and unbiased. Yes, fathers, such has been your gracious will, because the university theologies of dead letters were very proud and egoistic, like the Pharisee Simon, who invited Jesus for a meal and he did not wash his feet or did not honor him. He just wanted to test him, you know. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, because the Son represents Father. He is the omnipotent ambassador of our Father. Son, that's why Jesus, when in the temple, he said he is the Son of the Most High Elohim. And they said, he is making equal to Elohim, equal to God. That is what he means, ambassador, omnipotent ambassador. No one knows who the Son is except the Father. Who the Father is except the Father, and who the Father is except the Son. And only the Son knows Father, and Father knows the Son. That means our praises don't lie with people. We glorify our Father by preaching gospel. We don't care whether you like it or not, it's up to you. You have to get the gospel from our Father, not from me. As Jesus could not give gospel to Peter. Peter was once born. At Pentecost he got the very Spirit of God, or he was most drunk of all the 12. And anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal. Remember Jesus said to Peter, what do you think of me? Then he said, you are the living Christ of living God. That was the revelation that was that Son, Christ Jesus, wishes to know, that he should know, you know. Then what was the reaction? He became, I know gospel now. He became egoistic. He became very proud. And then when Jesus said, I'm going to Jerusalem, they will kill me, all this. He took him by his hand. What the hell you are talking about? Nonsense. How can somebody kill you? You make the dead people alive and all that. How can you die? Then Jesus rebuked him, you know, because he had become, he could not understand, you know, gospel. He became that too proud of the, that, I know gospel, no. You have to be humble. Turning to his laboring brethren and not the once-born disciples of the rabbis, in private he said, the inner one, you know, blessed are the wise that see what you see. Those 70, what they did, you know, and they saw it. For I say to you, many prophets and kings desire to see what you see. Prophets are, you know, the messengers. Prophets are not saints. So here you have prophets. the whip masters of the rabbis, and here we are saint. That is, in Christ Jesus we are saint, the sons of the Most High. John the Baptist was the last prophet, and no law and prophet after that. Luke 16, verse 16. So, we are ushered into the royal kingdom of God, not into the vineyard of our Father, which has a narrow gate. You have to find it yourself, if you long for gospel. For I say to you, many prophets and kings desire to see what you see. Now in India we have a prophet Krishna, Ramchandra and Krishna. They were prophets. Ramchandra was of Vishnu and Krishna was of Shiva. Shiva means the primal Adam, greater than the Ramchandra. But each played their own role. So he went to see his relative, and they were in big palaces and other things. He did not go into the palace. He went to the hut of a saint. His name was Bidhar. So he stayed overnight with him and listened to his sermon or gospel. So mean these prophets are subject to saints. Saints are sons of the Most High. Prophets are sons of Yahweh, which we call Brahma or Allah. No, sorry, Khuda. Khuda is the Lord of nature. Allah is our supernatural father of spirits. Kings desire to see what you see, but did not see it. And even Herod desired to see Jesus, you know, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it, because they were allowed scriptural knowledge and not his word. The worldly people, they can't have his word. Only scripture knowledge was given by their rabbis. If anybody was seeking his word, he had to leave the town and go to wilderness, out of the boundary of the regime of the rabbi. Remember Thomas, one of the 12, he went to South India. Over there, the Brahmins was not inefficient, and he preached gospel there. Because what applied to flesh, the opposite applied to spirit. So that was confusing the once-born people. So they complained to their rabbis or to their Brahmins or asked them questions, you know, or even telling them what is right and wrong. They were not happy. So that's why they killed him, you know, because they were not inefficient, and the people over there, they were good. Because in their name, they had four names. His name, father's name, village name, and surname. By this person is recognized. If he takes bribe, then the person will go to his father and tell him, your son took bribe from me. So they had shame, so they had the dharma, or faith in God. So his word, not the Oral Torah, which is by the grace of our Father. You can't have Oral Torah or His Word without the grace of our Father. So that is the exposition. I hope you understand. But gospel gets written over your heart and nobody can give you, and it's only received by the grace of our Father.